Hi guys. So today for science, what we're going to do is start our very last lesson in chapter 3. So we're on lesson 6. This was a very, very long chapter, but it had a lot of cool information, didn't it? I know a lot of you guys are animal fans, and that's what this chapter was about. Okay, so we're going to finish up our last lesson. So we're on lesson 6, and we're going to do part of it today, part of it tomorrow, and then next week we'll work on studying for our test. And then I probably will try to squeeze that test in on the 29th, okay? So that would be Friday. Okay, so I'll give you everything you need to prepare for it. All you'll have to do is look at the study guide that I give you, and I'll probably make up some sort of flashcards for you too. But just make sure you study, and then Friday your exam should be a piece of cake, okay? All right, so let's start lesson 6 of chapter 3. We are on pages 118 and 119 in your science book, which looks like this, okay? So page 118 and 119, if you need a little bit of extra time to get there, make sure that you pause the video because we are going to go on, but you need to be looking at this, okay? So let's go ahead and look at the top of page 118. It says, how do animals respond to their environment? Well, first off, what's an environment? Environment is where they live, so everything around them. So how do they respond to that? Okay, that is what we're learning about. So let's go ahead and look at that, envision it, those monkeys at the top of the page. Our question is, tell how these monkeys are responding to their environment. How are they responding to their environment? What is their environment? What does it look like? Well, I see a lot of white, right? So that would be probably a lot of snow. So we know their environment is cold. So what are they doing because it's cold outside? They're huddling together, aren't they? They're snuggling together to try to have their body weight keep them, or have each of their bodies keep them even warmer. So their body warmth is what they're using to stay warm. And they're using each other's body warmth too to kind of merge together, cuddle together, and stay warmer, okay? So that's what they're doing. Let's go ahead and look at the My Planet Diary. Ooh, it says there's a misconception. Misconception means that something that's misunderstood. So something that people don't understand. Let's go ahead and read that. Have you ever heard that bats cannot see? A common misconception about bats is that they are blind. Have you guys ever heard of the simile, blind as a bat? Have you ever heard of that? Blind as a bat means that so if it's saying the girl was blind as a bat, it's comparing the girl to the bat and saying that she's blind, right? Okay, so a common misconception about bats is that they're blind. Some bats use something called echolocation to locate prey, such as insects. Echolocation uses sound energy. Bats make a sound and then hear the echo as it bounces off the object, such as a delicious mosquito. So we know by the word misconception meaning it's not understood, bats actually can see, okay? A lot of people misunderstand and think that they can't, but they actually can. And the reason they think that they can't is because a lot of the time bats use echolocation to figure out where their prey is. So their prey, their food, right? Echolocation is they will squeal or screech or whatever they do to make noise. Okay, and they will listen to it coming back at them, so the echo coming back, and they'll know just by that where that prey is, okay? So that echo coming back to them will tell them where different objects are, okay, because they have very good ears too. Then the bat knows how far away and in what direction the insect is flying. Because bats can find prey in the dark, many people have assumed that they are blind. But all types of bats have eyes that can see. They can see only in black, white, and shades of gray. So they can see, okay, we have that figured out, but they can only see in black and white and like different shades of gray too. But they also have very good ears and they can hunt in the dark. So that echolocation helps them be able to hunt in the dark. Let's go ahead and look at our question by the pencil. It says, how can some bats get information from their environments? Okay, they can see, right? But what's the other thing that they can do? What do they use? Starts with an E. Go ahead and look up in your passage. Echolocation, right? So we can say some bats use echolocation and some bats also use sight. So they actually use two things. Okay, let's go ahead and look at the next page, 119. And up at the very top it says, unlock the big question. I will know how animals respond to their environment and get what they need. Words to know. We have stimulus and insect. You guys should know what an insect is. Okay, let's go ahead and read about animal behaviors. Have you ever tried to touch a turtle? If so, you may have seen a typical behavior of turtles. When a turtle feels threatened, it may pull its head back into its shell. This behavior protects the turtle from another animal. Okay, so if you can't really touch a turtle without it going back into its shell. Same thing if you've ever tried to touch a snail or a hermit crab, okay? A lot of the times when you get near them, whenever your hands start to go to touch them, they crawl back in their shell. Behaviors are the ways that animals act. Every behavior is caused by a stimulus. Can you say that word, stimulus? Okay, that's our first vocabulary word. A stimulus is something that causes a reaction to a living thing. Some behaviors are responses to stimuli in the environment. When a turtle pulls its head back in its shell, it is reacting to something it has heard, seen, or smelled in its environment. Other behaviors are responses to stimuli inside an animal. For example, hunger is a stimulus that causes animals to look for food and eat. So it's kind of like cause and effect, if you think about it like that. So we have the stimulus, which is kind of like the cause. Okay, what is happening? Okay, think about whenever you're hungry. What is happening? You're hungry, right? So what's the effect? What do you do because you're hungry? You eat something. Okay, so same concept. Stimulus is like the cause. So what happens to cause that effect? Okay, a turtle. The stimulus would be something that the animal smells or hears or sees. Okay, that would be the stimulus. So that would be the turtle smelling, hearing, or seeing something. And the reaction would be that animal or the turtle would crawl up in its shell. Okay, so same thing, kind of like cause and effect. The stimulus is the cause. That's what is happening to cause that effect. Okay, so that's a good way to look at that. Let's go ahead and look at the picture in the caption. It says the box turtle is hiding in its shell. We can see that box turtle right there. Number one says apply. Give an example of a stimulus that might cause a turtle to pull its head into its shell. So what might cause a turtle to pull its head into a shell? Go ahead and write that answer down. A turtle might pull its head into a shell if you go to reach for it, or if a person steps by it, right? Because if they step close to it, then it's gonna hear, it's gonna smell, it's gonna see a foot, and it's gonna pull itself into its shell because it gets scared that something's going to hurt it, okay? Okay, I have a few questions for you. Recognize, what is the plural term of stimulus? So you can look at that word stimulus. And actually it is in our passage. It says a stimulus is something that causes a reaction to a living thing. Some behaviors are responses to stimuli in an environment. So stimuli is the plural form. Stimulus is one. Okay, so what is the stimulus that would cause the turtle to pull its head back in the shell? You walking beside it. Stimuli is more than one. Okay, so more than one stimulus. So stimuli would be the plural meaning more than one, form of stimulus. Describe, identify two examples of behaviors that you have observed in animals. So what are two behaviors that you observe in animals? Think about what they do outside. What do birds do a lot of the times? They build nests, right? Yeah, they build nests. That would be one of their behaviors. They also fly south for the winter. Yeah, that would be a behavior. What about squirrels? What do they usually do a lot of the times for food? They gather acorns, right? They will gather their food. So that would be another behavior that we see in animals. Classify. An insect lands on a deer's ear. The deer flicks its ear, sending the insect flying away. What is the stimulus? Okay, so what's the stimulus of this? Think about what the cause is. Okay. Okay, the cause is that an insect would land on the deer's ear. Okay, and so what's the effect? What's the behavior? The deer flicks its ear, right? Yeah, so the behavior would be that the deer would flick its ear. Why did it flick its ear? What was the stimulus? Because a bug landed on it. Okay, cause and effect, right? Very similar. Okay, so go ahead, go to the next slide, and we will continue on reading this lesson.